what my mama refers to as a high-functioning impressive. Like Alexander, this hit around puberty. I consider this a legacy from my Jewish foremothers that hit right around the same time as like the birthing hips and like the light cocoa dusting of body hair to make my life miserable when I was 12. Like that all happened around the same time. And I would just like to say, stop me if this gets familiar, ladies in the audience, but it's really hard to be a depressive teenage girl. It is very, very difficult. Okay? I have none of the coping mechanisms I have now, okay? You can't drink. You're 14. You're not supposed to be funny. No one wants teenage girls to be funny.
14-year-olds aren't funny.
They're not funny. That's true. None of them are. You try some. I believe them. Really, I was a pleaser, and the thing that people most want from teenage girls is to be happy, which I was not. And the more I tried to be happy, the more depressed I was. It was a terrible circle. And the other problem is that teenage girl statuses are, you get told that they're petty all the time, that you're not supposed to be sad about these things, that you don't have anything to be sad about. So that taught me that my sadness didn't matter and was wrong, and so I didn't matter.